Hello, it's Dr. Murray Motion. Welcome back. We're going to dive straight into this really simple slime material. And you can use the same techniques you learn here to make anything using subsurface scattering and blender. So you can make anything like milk, honey, marble, or blood. Open up your scene in Blender that you want to add slime to. I recommend fluid simulations, especially using the Flip Fluids add-on. I'm going to be using this simulation, which patrons can download for just $3 a month, but you can use this in any scene as well. And we're going to be using cycles, but you can use these same techniques for eevee as well. We want to visualize what this looks like at the moment with no material, but before we do that, save your scene because anything with rendering, anything intensive can crash Blender. Now we'll press Z and R to go into rendered view, and we'll press Control B to draw this render boundary so we don't waste render time on anything outside of our area. And let's make it even smaller actually, so we're only rendering the actual slime material. Now let's go into the shading workspace. Again, visualize the rendered view and let's add a new material. Now we want to be able to control the level of subsurface scattering. So we want this color and this color to be exactly the same, the base color and the subsurface color. We'll do that with Shift A, adding, and we search for RGB. And we're going to have an RGB color as an input. So this is going to go into the base color and the subsurface color. Now let's make this bright green because that's the classic slime color. And we can see that the base color is what we're seeing now because subsurface is zero. But if we switch it all the way to one, it's still green. But you might notice that it does look a bit more subsurface-y, but it doesn't look a lot like a subsurface translucent material. And let's fix that now. So this subsurface radius thing used to really confuse me, but I found a really simple way to work with it. Because this has three variables and they correspond to red, green, and blue, red, green, and blue make colors. So you can just plug this into the subsurface radius. And let me show you how to have a little bit more control over the translucency of your subsurface material. So we're gonna Shift A, we're gonna search for a vector math node, and we're gonna slot this in between our input and the subsurface radius. Now, instead of adding, we want to multiply. So at the moment, it's taking our green color and it's multiplying it by zero. And so the surface radius is going to be zeros everywhere, which is very opaque. So this is a very low amount of subsurface scattering, if anything at all. If we select all of these and press one, we're now multiplying it by one. So the green color is passing through unchanged, and this is a nice base level of subsurface scattering. And if we increase this even further, we can get even more translucent. So we can have a material that's more translucent, more see-through, that's affected more by this subsurface scattering effect. So if we turn this up to 5, it should make it even more transparent. Let's do that. And you can see the material looks even thinner. Like you can even start to see the base through the goo here. You could crank this up really high, but after a while it starts losing its impact. But see now here at the bottom, it even looks a bit transparent, like the way that it's dark. And for comparison, let's bring it down to very low, like 0.1. See, this looks more like a normal material without subsurface. And we can check that by reducing this. So now, we're using zero subsurface. This is the base material. You can see that it looks very similar to this because this radius is low. So you can control the level of subsurface scattering in two ways. One is to use this slider, which mixes between a normal plasticky kind of material and subsurface scattering, and this radius. So the higher this radius is, the more pronounced the subsurface scattering effect. I think it's not obvious enough here. Let's see one. I think that's nicer, but it's still not very pronounced. Let's make it 5. And I think this is nice. This looks nice and slimy. If your material looks too shiny, you can play with the specular and the roughness. So to make it shinier, turn the specular up and the roughness down to make it less shiny, do the opposite. I like it at default, I'm gonna keep this. But an extra little thing, this isn't subsurface scattering, but it can help sell this slimy material, is a little bit of emission. It can make it look a bit like radioactive and glowy, which can look cool in the right scenes. So we're gonna use this same color just to minimize like having to copy and paste things. We're gonna plug it into the emission. And this is way too strong. It's washed out our scene. Let's make it zero. So this is what it looked like without any emission. Let's try 0.1. That's still too strong. Let's make it very subtle, 0.01. So some of the materials that I'll showcase at the beginning do have an emission. I think it makes more sense when there are more obstacles in the surroundings. So when it's passing through a water feature, you can really see the effect of the emission. When it's being poured into the oyster that the angel is holding, you can really see the effect of the emission material. Here it's less noticeable, but it's just something to bear in mind. So we're gonna keep emission at a nice low level, but I think this helps fill it out a little bit, makes it a bit less dark and boring in these flat areas. Now the really nice thing about this setup is it's very simple. And because we've used this input, we can change one color and change the whole look of the material. So let's say you're not sure if you want a green slime, you can make it blue. And this looks very nice. It's less slimy, but it looks nice. Kind of like an icing almost. Almost looks tasty. I think almost any color can look good with this setup. So this is what purple looks like, again, very nice. You can see the subsurface scattering because of the difference in the color. Like here where it's nice and thin, it's quite white. It's also near the light. Here where it's further from the light and it's thicker, it's darker. I quite like these pastel-y slime materials, which I've kind of discovered just now. So lots of possibilities from a really simple setup. So I hope you enjoyed this short video. Thank you to everyone who voted on my recent poll. So this was tied first for the most requested tutorial. And I hope you've enjoyed it. If you want this exact scene, so you can try the material in this setup, it's gonna be available on Patreon for just $3. So check the description for a link, and I'll also have a link on screen. Thanks very much for watching, like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.